Echo and Harper Audio present A Cruelty Special to Our Species Poems by Emily Jungmin Yoon. This is the author. Author's note. For me, poetry provides a space in which intertwined languages and historical narratives are celebrated, a space in which I conceive disasters, failures, and traumas, lending them my own perspective, dimension, and articulation. My poetry does not exist to answer, but rather to continue asking questions about my immigrant, ESL, Korean, and womanly experiences, and the violent history of 20th century Korea. As poems on the comfort women of the Japanese Empire are in the heart of this collection, I'd like to mention my position in writing their stories. In 1991, the year of my birth, Kim Hak-soon became the first former comfort woman to offer public testimony of her life as a sex slave. As more and more former comfort women of the Japanese Empire began to share their testimonies, it was clear they were speaking from within, not for a community. They put their voices together for reparations and recognition of their and the empire's history. I'd like my poetry to serve to amplify and speak these women's stories, not speak for them. I'd like my poetry to remind readers that even if a part of history may not seem to be relevant to their lives, it is. It is their reality too. An experience that is not mine is still part of the society and world that I occupy. It is crucial to know, listen, tell, and retell various stories, so we may better theorize and understand our existence. In the realm of poetry, one can transcend the sense of belonging confined by temporal and geographical lines. In this transcendence, I return to my departed ancestors, to their frustration of tongues and identities and experiences of diaspora, from the Japanese occupation to the turbulent years in Korea before my birth. Poetry is not just relief. Poetry is tension. Poetry is departure. Poetry is return. Poetry is memory. I wrote this book to say that one has the agency to command and preserve their own narrative. The Charge. An Ordinary Misfortune. Mine is the jam-packed train, the two-week cocktail, the statement by an American man at the bar, your life in Korea would have been a whole lot different without the U.S., meaning, be thankful. This question by a Canadian girl, a friend, why don't you guys just get along? The guys, Japan and Korea, meaning, move on. How do I answer that? Move on, girls on the train. Destination, comfort stations. Things a soldier can do, mount you before another soldier is done. Say, drink the soup made of human blood. Say, the Korean race should be erased from this earth. Tops down, bottoms up. Things erased, your name, your child, your history. Your new name, Fumiko, Hanako, Yoshiko. Name of the condom, charge number one. Name of the needle, compound 606. Salverson means an arsenic to save. Ratio 291, 29 soldiers per girl. Actual count, lost. Lost all. Shot, shot, shot. Everybody, give thanks. Comfort. On Wednesday, I ate plain yogurt, opened a notebook, Vivaldi, as I folded my laundry. It was his birthday. On Wednesday, it rained, on the succulents, on the surviving women. Tricked or taken, carted to Japanese soldiers. The condom said, attack number one. Rinsed for reuse. On Wednesday, I listened to The Four Seasons. It stopped raining, It never stopped raining. On Wednesdays, it rains. For the children they bore. For the children they could not bear. For the children they wore. Give them this day. Give them Vivaldi, violin. Give them the all-girls choir. L'inverno, come and gone. All four seasons, come and gone. On Wednesday, nothing happened. Rain evaporated, and so did the concertos. Wednesdays ago, the women, the girls, clutched each other. Who will live? Who will leave? Who believes this life? The world will be better after you and me. An ordinary misfortune. What is pressing? What is pressed? Or who? My grandmother, a woman, a teen. Her father presses the gate shut, presses her into a crate, the crate into a shed. She unfolds by morning, binds her chest. She walks unwomaned. An American soldier sees her and yells, "Stop over there," in Japanese, the language they've both learned. When she runs, she's unmistakably woman. She falls. He laughs. What is a body in a stolen country? Or whose? What is right in war? What is left in war? War hasn't left Korea. I have. I fold. I give up myself to you. Which one of you said, "Let's have raunchy Korean sex," to me? Which one of you didn't? Do you represent America to me? Did those soldiers to her? We didn't fear war. We feared the Allies, she said. Hello, Miss Pretty Bitch. The street drummer calls out in Korean, no doubt thinking it a compliment. A pleasant surprise. Cinched with red ribbons. For Christmas, the day, select theaters will gift us with The Interview, a comedy in which two American journalists ignite Kim Jong-un's face. Freedom has prevailed, the film star Seth Rogen says about the release. The same was thought at the time of Korea's release from the Japanese Empire, though then the Korean War began, and compared to war, what's so bad about a movie? Anyway, even war can be funny. And now a drummer in New York says, you got a smile that could light up the whole town. Though I'm not smiling, thinking about villages and cities of what became North Korea set on fire, sending puddles of twilight into sunless skies as if flames could stab. But his freedom of speech prevails. Freedom always prevails, which is why we get to see two Americans incinerate a Korean face on Christmas, hold our popcorn and chocolate bars, and laugh as the dictator explodes in tune to a pop song. Laugh as American soldiers would laugh at Korean children chanting, hello, hello, gibumi chocolate, with wartime hunger. Laugh as they choose which face to light up. An ordinary misfortune. The trouble with trees is that their bodies and limbs are too capable of burning, of living, capable of leaves, of leaving, charcoal, ash, and we think we have power. Capable, 1561, from late Latin, capabilis, receptive. Unit 731 of the Japanese Empire injects us with monkey blood. Our limbs are not receptive, capable, used by theologians, from Latin, capex, able to hold much, our living bodies and extracted children not holding, not capable, capere, to take, grasp, lay hold, catch, undertake, be large enough for, comprehend. How to take, how to grasp, comprehend, our limbs catch fire, taken, our bodies not large enough, capable, Sanskrit, kapati, two handfuls.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.